Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Amen.
Out to all the words. We thank God for your prayers.
Amen.
You would have come out on Tuesday evening and lay hands on the prayer requests and ask God's blessing to honor those requests. I want to thank God for some of those prayers on my part. It's been answered, being answered, and been answered.
Yes, thank God.
Mother Louise is doing better. She had walked pretty much from the other day, I believe. Right, Sister Joyce? So, she's doing better. Thank God for your prayers. We continue to pray for Mother Louise.
Amen.
Zolis and Ray, continue to pray for them.
Yes.
I'm taking on myself to ask you to pray for Ray and Lily's spirit as well as their physical.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Well, I said that simply because we all going to stand before the judgment one day.
Mm-hmm.
And God is going to examine us, whether we know it or not, whether we believe it or not.
Yes, sir.
Just like the judge is here today. They're not other than God. So we got to give an account of how we could get up and go other places and do other things, and we couldn't spring up the same energy to do but the work of the ministry.
Amen.
Amen. So please pray for this wisdom to come to the people of God. That the eyes, our eyes will be enlightened to do what God wants us to do. Sister Black, sister, last Sunday morning as I was here, I got a text message that she'd went with a sister, met a sister at the emergency room. Her blood pressure was so high until it blinded one of her eyes. So, Missionary Franklin and Brittany and myself went down to Westchester to visit with her and pray with her. And we got a report on Friday that she's home.
Amen.
She still can't see out of the left eye, but she's home and she's done a lot better. She's much less pain. So we thank God for your prayers for that. And the prayers for the building, I thank God for your prayers. Thank the working, coming together. However, the job turned out to be larger than expected. So therefore we have to go through more channels than we expected to go through. Got to go through the historic board. We got to go through the zoning board, different things like this. Contracted, they went and requested a permit to pay for permit of $258. But it was only designated for a certain amount of work. Since this work is going to be a major work, they had to resubmit the proposal of the contract so that, and now they resubmit that, dealing with a major work, we're dealing with historical, we're dealing with zoning board, all of these things. So, I have an appointment to meet with Senator Lauren on Thursday at 2 o'clock. And hopefully I'll be able to meet with Mrs. Yeatrum from the Newburgh Honorary, which has a connection with the Kaplan Foundation on tomorrow or Tuesday. So we still moving forward. We're getting the letters out, the donation form, donations, applications, and all this. We're getting them out. Brother Lauren is getting good results with his. And we're thankful for that. And I am blessed. I am just so thankful for God is good. We did a show here Friday, Thursday night, we had a wake, and then Friday at 11 o'clock, we did a funeral, and I did the eulogy, and the, it was a church full of people. You see, they were putting more seats in the back. In fact, we had seats all the way down. And got some of the community work yesterday, and my grandson asked to move the last seat on each side. So we are thankful for all the things that have been taking place. Everything is looking great. Amen. So keep us in prayer. Keep us in your heart, in your mind. God is moving forward. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Brother Lauren.
In reference to the church, I've been putting out the donations I did to Pastor Timothy. But we need your help. Pastor's very busy and he's doing all he can by himself. For the services, I'll give you the letters that I had in my car. Take 5, 6, 7, 8. Because we all know somebody. It's called a warm marketing business. The cleaners, laundry, the dentist, the doctor. Give them a letter, donation, and say, hey, can you please help the church? Most people will give you something. At my job, I got like 3 people. If they will give me a dollar, I said, thank you for the dollar. Because a dollar times $10,000, and that's, you know, 10 people, $10,000, $10,000. So, you know, please help us and help us to be, you know, it's for our building. We need your help. The other thing I'll say is this lady in the Bronx, she's called Share Shoes. She wants to get 400,000 shoes to Haiti. So, they have a big event November 12th this month, I mean, of next month. So, if you have any old shoes that you want to get rid of, she just wants you to get some rubber band shoes. You got to get some kids' shoes versus adult mid shoes, and I'll take them out to the Bronx in November, and then I'll take some of these shoes to Haiti. The last thing is we're going to go to New Orleans January 8th. We've been gone like 6 days. So if you want to come, let me know. And that's January 8th to like the 12th to New Orleans. Okay? Pastor? Elvin?
I'm singing a small song. Amen. Just encourage us for the word. Let me touch you and see if you are real. Even though I know my heart and hand can heal. But sometimes I get discouraged and I need your strength and shield. Jesus, let me touch you and see if you are real. Sometimes to me you seem so far away, yeah. And I'm wondering how to make it through. Jesus, let me touch you and see if you are real. 'Cause when I'm down, let me touch you, let me touch you. When I'm lonely, let me touch you, let me touch you. When I'm discouraged, let me touch you, let me touch you, like I never had before. Lord, I need you more and more. Jesus, let me touch you and see if you are real. Bless you.
The food,
oh, no, you can open that.
Some nourishment, the word of God. Let us stand. We thank God for the diligence of Pastor Gil Wilson being here on the second Sunday of every month. Mind and soul, and don't forget your strength. Please.